कवर्ड द गाइडेड मीडिया, दैट इज योर वायर्ड और बाउंडेड मीडिया. मोस्ट ऑफ द आई थिंक मोस्टली इट इज कवर्ड. सो आई थिंक यू आर अवेयर ऑफ दैट. ट्विस्टेड पेयर केबल वी हैव डन. देर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ केबल, अनशील्डेड एंड शील्डेड. सो अगेन द एडवांटेजेस एंड डिसएडवांटेजेस आर ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड. एंड अनदर वन इज योर कोएक्सियल केबल. सो आई थिंक आई हैव अगेन मेक श्योर दैट दिस डायग्राम इज रॉन्ग हेयर. सो विद दिस जैकेट देयर इज अगेन वन मोर इंसुलेशन इंसुलेटर. आफ्टर दैट देयर इज अ शील्ड एंड देन देयर इज अ इंसुलेटर. सो दिस मेटल शील्ड इज सैंडविच्ड बिटवीन टू इंसुलेटर. कीप दैट इन माइंड. ओके, सो आई विल करेक्ट द डायग्राम ऑल्सो, बट इट्स देयर इज एडिशनल इंसुलेटर देयर. ओके, so till now all the devices, all the cables that we have studied, they are there has been some kind of loss by using the cables. Okay, so most of the time if you use coaxial cable, if you use twisted pair cable, or if you use shielded or unshielded twisted pair cable, during the transmission there will be some kind of interference. Those signal loss will be there, or due to the metal shield get heated, the signal is also get lost it in the way. So this is not there will be some kind of a loss, like 10%, 20%. There will always be a certain kind of a loss in the transmission till the cables that we have studied. Okay, so how to tackle these kind of losses? They are that we do not want any kind of a loss in the transmission. So we have invented something called a fiber optic or optical fiber cable. Okay, so this is one of the cable that has zero kind of loss when we are communicating using this cable. Okay, so if you are connecting two devices between each other, there is zero loss. There is no kind of heating going on between the conductor or anything. So it is one of the efficient. It is one of the efficient cable that we used right now for communication also, or for establishing computer networks. Okay, so I'll just show you. There's a little bit of a concept that if you have studied 10th class science, that is the same concept. I'll explain you also. If there is a chapter called reflection and refraction in your 10th class science. Okay, so if you haven't studied, I will only explain you that point where it is only will explain you those things that are necessary to understand the concept of fiber optic. Okay, so this is in the part of reflection and refraction. Okay, so in order to understand how optical fiber works, you have to understand how reflection and refraction works. Okay, so suppose this is there are two kinds of medium, that are denser one and that lighter one. Okay, so I think this particular medium I will call it that this is a more dense medium, and I'll call this medium as less dense medium. Okay, so dense means that if you are going from water to air, so you are going from a denser medium to a less dense medium. Okay, so something like that. Okay, so when now this I call this particular thing a surface. Okay, so now when the light goes from more denser towards a lighter, less dense material, the light will tend to move towards the surface. Okay, so if I draw a perpendicular angle there at the point where you are coming into different medium, so I'll call this particular thing as L. So this L is your incidence angle. Okay, so this L is your incidence angle. Okay, so this when you are going from a more dense medium to less dense medium, the light just bends towards the surface. Okay, so this is one point, and I know that it will start bending. So I know one concept, that the light will start to bend. If I go from more dense medium to less dense medium, the light will start to bend towards the surface. Okay, so what I'll do, I'll try to increase the angle of incidence. Okay, so here it was L. Now here I'll increase a little bit of this angle. Okay, so this is a little bit increased. I increase the angle, so something like this will happen. Okay, so it is again moving towards the surface. Again, I'll start to increase the angle. So what will happen at a particular amount of time? Suppose this is again I'll try to bend the angle. Now this is increased there. So what happens is angle runs alongside the surface. Okay, so when this particular thing happens, that at such a point when the incidence angle is set in such a point that the reflected ray becomes normal to the surface, this particular angle is referred to as a critical angle. Okay, so what is a critical angle? When the angle of incident is set in such a way such that the reflected or refracted, such that this is refraction, keep that in mind, this particular thing is called refraction, such that the refraction or refracted ray moves alongside the surface, then L is called your critical angle. Okay, so now what I'll do, I'll try to increase the angle after that. Okay, so this is this, and I'll try to increase the angle. This one. Okay, so when that happens, there is a concept called the light is totally reflected back. Okay, so this particular concept or phenomena is called total internal reflection. Total internal reflection. Okay, so in this case, if I say now this, at this my angle of incidence is less than critical angle, I'll say my angle of incidence is less than critical angle, because to be a critical angle, the refracted ray has to be normal alongside the surface. Okay, here my again angle of incident is less than the critical angle. Here my angle of incidence is equal to critical angle. At this particular time, my angle of incidence is greater than critical angle. Okay, so when the angle of incidence becomes greater than the critical angle, total internal reflection comes into place. Okay, so every light that you are trying to transmit from a more denser medium, so keep in mind, this is again more dense medium, this is less dense. From a more dense medium to a less dense medium, all the light is reflected back in it all entirety. Okay, so entirely the light get reflected back without any loss. Okay, so there is no particles of light that are there. All the light that is going from a more denser medium is again reflected back along the same dense medium. Okay, so that is why there are phenomena like in very hot summer on your roads, you tend to see some particles of water, but exactly when you come very near to it, there will be no water. Okay, so that is because this particular thing is called a mirage. This mirage, that mirages are created using this phenomena, that is your total internal reflection. That total internal reflection will come into play when your angle of incidence becomes greater than the critical angle. So what is a critical angle? The critical angle is when the reflected angle becomes normal along the surface. Okay, so now this same phenomena is used in optical fiber. There are three main parts to optical fiber. First is your core, second is your cladding, and third is your plastic cover. So you already know the plastic cover or a jacket. Okay, so this is just a metal covering. There is main two parts are this one, core and cladding. Okay, so how it is arranged here, it is the optical fiber looks like this one. Okay, so this particular part will be your cladding and this particular part will be your core. Okay, so this is arranged in this particular way. Okay, so this is again your cladding. Okay, so outside of that there will be your plastic covering and plastic. Okay, something like this. Okay, so now we have simulated the same particular things that we know about the total internal reflection. So this core part is a less denser area. This is a less dense area. No, sorry, it is a more dense area, and the cladding part is a less dense area. Okay, so now from a light source, you try to reflect, or you try to increase the incident angle will always be greater here than the critical angle. So that is why all the light source will bounce back and your communication will take place into something like this. Okay, so that is how if you are in optical fiber, and they say that in optical fiber that you have 100 Mbps speed, the speed will always be 100 Mbps. It will not be less than that. Okay, but if you are connected through a coaxial cable or a twisted pair cable or untwisted pair cable, if they are saying that you have 100 Mbps speed, most of the time it will actually be like 80 to 70 to 80 Mbps, because there are many things that are lost. There are many signals that will be lost on the way. Okay, so that is why the optical fiber is one of the effective or efficient wire that we used when we require no loss. Okay, so there is no particular disadvantage of this optical fiber. Only one disadvantage is that it's a little bit costly. It is not very much costly, but it is costly. Okay, so only one disadvantage to it, but otherwise this optical. Another thing is that it is very difficult to repair. Okay, so if a particular optical wire is there is some breakage, so there are particular equipments that are present to again detect up the angle of incident that should be greater than equal to 90. If the break is there, so there are particular devices that are there that ensures that the incidence angle is always greater than the critical angle, so that there is a total internal reflection. Okay, so it is difficult to repair, so most of the time they will totally replace the whole cable, but there are equipment that is there to repair it also. Okay, so the advantages of this one is fiber optic. So the advantages of this one is higher bandwidth. There will be greater bandwidth, faster speeds, longer distances you can also transfer. There is no loss. There is no repeater will be used in this communication. So there is no use of a repeater in this. You can easily transmit your signal at the same intensity. Okay, so there is no usage of repeater in this optical fiber. Better reliability, so it is more reliable than it, and it is thinner and sturdier. Okay, so it does not break very easily, but still if it breaks, it is a little difficult to repair. Okay, so now the other part is your unguided transmission. So you can look it upon yourself, what is unguided transmission. So it is basically only three waves, the three or four waves. The waves are your radio waves, your microwaves, your ultraviolet or infrared rays. Okay, so just all the things that are there are defined already there. So you can look at the PPD and you can easily take a look at all the waves that are given in there. Okay, so it's very easy to understand. It is not very difficult. I think you can do it yourself. If you have any kind of a problem, just let me know. Okay, so I'll you do this particular topic yourself. I'll just want to tell you one thing in this particular area, the wireless transmission. There is something called electromagnetic spectrum. Okay, so just wait a second. Yeah, okay, this one. Okay, so electromagnetic spectrum contains all the waves that are present already in our spectrum, like ultraviolet, microwave, light waves, all are already there. Okay, so the range of this one is it's radio waves. Suppose this is ultraviolet, electromagnetic spectrum. Suppose this is electromagnetic spectrum. Okay, so in this spectrum, your radio wave रेडियो एंड योर माइक्रोवेव विल कवर दिस रेंज फ्रॉम 3 किलो हर्ट्स. जस्ट लेट मी टेक अ लुक एट इट द डायग्राम. ओके, सो इट्स 3 किलो हर्ट्स टू 300 गीगाहर्ट्स. ओके, सो इन दैट रेंज योर रेडियो एंड माइक्रोवेव विल बी ट्रांसमिटेड. ओके, सो इफ एनी वेव इज एग्जिस्ट इन दिस पर्टिकुलर रेंज, यू कैन कॉल आइदर इट विल बी अ रेडियो वेव और इट विल बी अ माइक्रोवेव. ओके, सो फ्रॉम 300 गीगाहर्ट्स टू 400 टेराहर्ट्स द वेव इज योर इंफ्रारेड वेव. एंड द लास्ट वन फ्रॉम दिस इज रेयरली यूज बट स्टिल फॉर 400 to 900 टेराहर्ट्स वी यूज समथिंग कॉल्ड लाइट वेव. ओके, सो इन दिस पर्टिकुलर स्पेक्ट्रम देर आर अदर वेव्स ऑल्सो लाइक अल्ट्रा वायलेट रे और अदर थिंग्स, बट अल्ट्रा वायलेट रेज आर नॉट यूज फॉर कम्युनिकेशन बिकॉज इट इज हार्मफुल फॉर ह्यूमन्स एज वेल. ओके, सो यू ऑलरेडी नो दैट देर आर, बिकॉज इफ यू नो अबाउट दिस दैट द रिसर्च इज स्टिल गोइंग ऑन दैट द टेलीकम्युनिकेशन सिग्नल कॉजेज डिस्ट्रेस इन ह्यूमन्स एज वेल एज एनिमल्स एंड पर्टिकुलरली दे आर कॉजिंग डिस्ट्रेस इन बर्ड्स. ओके, बट एक्चुअली इट इज समथिंग कॉन्क्रीट इज नॉट, देर इज नो सच एविडेंस राइट नाउ देयर दैट दिस पर्टिकुलर टेलीकम्युनिकेशन पुट अ डिस्ट्रेस टू पर्टिकुलर बर्ड्स और अ पर्टिकुलर ह्यूमन्स. स्टिल द रिसर्च इज गोइंग ऑन, बट Who can say what exactly are these? But still, we are using the radio as well as microwaves till now also. So there is again, I think in the 1800s, there was one person that has an allergy to the radio or something called telecommunication waves. So what happened is that person got rashes around its all of the body when there is a signal that is transmitted through unguided medium. So what the person did that he prepared his case and transfer and put the case onto complained it in a court. Okay, so the court does not just hasn't favored that person because only that person is facing a particular allergic reaction towards this radio and microwave. So there are people that are allergic to various kind of waves that are used in right now and used in antennas, but there are not much persons. Okay, so that particular person that because of this one person, the judge is not able to give the decision in its favor, but there are many people after that. There are many people arises that faces the same problem. So what they do is they built a Faraday cage. So Faraday cage is that where any no unguided medium signal can come in. So they used to live like that. All the persons that are allergic to various kind of radio waves or other microwaves that are used in transmission, they used to live inside a Faraday cage. So after that, there is one place, I do not remember the name of the place, that where there is no kind of unguided media transmission or any kind of a transmission is going on. So all the communication is via wires. So most of the people that are facing allergy towards a particular telecommunication waves, they live there to avoid any kind of a problem. So it happens that some humans are allergic to telecommunication waves which are used for nowadays transmission, but it is very, very rare. So it will be like 1, 2, or 10 persons around the whole out of the whole population of Earth, it will be around 10 to 12 people, so not more than that. Okay, so now I think you can read about this. There is also microwave transmission, and there is also satellite transmission is also, I think, in this particular thing. Okay, so all the disadvantages and not disadvantages and advantages of already is already defined there. So it is a simple read. You can take a look around it. It is very simple to understand. Okay, so now I'm moving towards the next topic, that is your switching. Okay, so if I see switching. So again, it's a very interesting topic. Actually, it's very easy to understand, but before I will just get a little bit of detail in this particular switching particular switching technique called packet switching. Okay, so I'll also show you that how different packets get transferred in parallel in across all the communication routers or in all the different kind of network devices. Okay, I'll take example and I show you that how exactly is this happening around the world right now. Okay, so before going on further, I'll tell you a little bit of a story. The story was that there was a company that is known as Western Union. I think you may have heard about this right now. This company, that Western Union Money Transfer, you know that it's a money transfer company. But earlier, in the early 1800s, this particular company is known for the telegram services. Okay, so it is very very big company, and all the telegrams are communicated through this company only. Okay, so that was the peak of this company, is that to provide telegram services to all the people that exist there. Okay, so now to this company, you may have heard about him. That is Graham Bell. That is the inventor of your telephone. So when Graham Bell invented telephone, he come towards this Western Union company and said that I have a new invention that you can use. So he demonstrated it by going into that other room and putting a telephone there and putting a telephone here, and it shows that it can connect to different devices and you can easily talk it. So what is the use of telegram? But instead of appreciating the invention, the people at Western Union said that this particular technology is not for adults, it can be used for children. So if you know that children are used to take a cup, and they used to connect the different cups or cardboard cups using a thread. So they thought of this particular technology like that. Okay, so they are thinking that it is like the cup technology, but it will be useful for children, but it is not meant for adults. Okay, so Graham Bell asked around like $1 lakh for the license of this technology, but the Western Union refused it, and they said they can easily purchase this particular technology from Graham Bell, but they just thought that it is not a resource that will be used anywhere further, because it is just because the demonstration is just between two telephones. Okay, so there is no like long range telephones or anything like that. So they have not thought about they have not thought beyond a particular point that this particular technology can extend. So they ignored the idea. So what this person did is that this person given this technologies to different merchants, that there are many merchants. They have Graham Bell have given this particular technology to different merchants that exist in the city, and they said, "I'm giving you the license for free. Just make the telephones and spread this across the town." Okay. So what they did, this merchant have obtained the technology for free. They just started to manufacture the telephones, and they began to advertise and said, starting selling the telephone sets. But initially, actually, it was used. This telephone phones were particularly used for rich people. So what they do, they just place a telephone in their home, and they place a telephone at the other that will be at other room where the maids are present. So what they do, they used to call the maids to come here and do some particular work. So only this purposes the rich people were using this telephone, because because it's very simple, that the wire the long the wire is, the long the communication is. So initially it was started like that, but afterward this merchant tried to lay wires across the town. So in the starting of 1900s, they are able to cover the whole town, the whole country, the whole continent across these wires. Okay, so the communication between people becomes so much easy. Okay, so because of the because of the efforts of these merchants, we are able to see the growth of the telephone that exists right now also. Okay, so now what they do, these merchants, now they merged together and formed a company called AT&T. Okay, so you might have heard about this. It's a very popular company in the US, and this AT&T company afterward, that because the telephone network became so successful, nobody is there to send a telegram to a particular person. But because for a telegram, you can only send like 2-3 words. Every word cost very high. So that is why this, with the help of the telephone, you will be able to call to a person and talk to like hours for that person. And there is no need. It is not that much costly as a telegram, and you can communicate more. So what they did is, this AT&T purchased this company, that is your Western Union, and used it for other purposes, that is your money transfer. Okay, so there is a simple story that how a particular company did not watch the evolution, that how this particular technology will evolute the further coming of communication. So how we are starting with the telegrams, and we evolved this particular thing into your telephones. And this particular telephone networks are now involved into something called as computer networks, or your modern age internet. Okay, so that is now. I will also show you why did I tell you this particular story, because at the starting of telephone, there are also many problems. Okay, so when you are increasing the range from a country to a country, there are so many problems in between. So that is why this telephone lines will works as a foundation. Okay, so any problem that occurs in computer network, we always refer towards a telephone network, that what we have done in telephone networks to solve this problem. Okay, so most of the solution that are already defined in telephone network, that are already defined, we are still using in computer networks. Okay, so the already defined, the researchers have already defined solutions in telephone network that are already being used in the computer network in the same way. Okay, so that is the advantage of defining a particular base that is properly defined. Now we can extend on that base. Okay, so there are also other things that are not in telephone network that have a solution, but still this particular telephone network served a very great purpose in establishing your modern age internet. Okay, so now see the first switching. Now switching is what? The switching is forwarding a packet from one device to another. Okay, so from port to port, it can be from port to port, and port to port, you know, if your PC has an Ethernet port, and it can be connected to other Ethernet port to forward the simple packets. Okay, so now the switching can be of two types. It is majorly divided into two types. First is connectionless, and second is connection oriented. Okay, so connection oriented is reliable, because in this you have to first establish connection. This is the proper step. Okay, so whatever is the time required to it, it is a proper step. First is establish connection. Second is you want to do communication with anyone, you do communication. Third is you have to break the connection or tear down connection. Okay, so there are these three steps. Okay, so why I'm calling this connection oriented a more reliable one, because already the path between a sender and receiver is already defined there. So that is why that is one of the most preferred mode of communication. So connectionless is first of all, it is automatic. So first of all, there is no kind of connection establishment time required or tear down time required in it. Okay, so it is automatic. It is automatic in the way that like I've explained you, that it stores certain kind of routing tables or bridge table that is able to communicate automatically without any need of manual intervention. Okay, so acknowledgement in this are also optional. So that is why I said that it is not very, what do I call it, not very reliable. Okay, so now I show you that circuit switching is a previous technique. It is hardware technique, hardware based technique that we used in the early days of telephone network. Okay, so I'll now to make you understand when two nodes communicate with each other over a dedicated, so it is very very important point here that you have to communicate over a dedicated communication path. Okay, so the path is already defined. There is no need to define a path when you are connected from one device to another. The path is already defined. Okay, so I'll give you an example to that so that you will understand this one. Okay, so suppose this is, I'm talking about circuit switching. Okay, so now in circuit switching, what you see, suppose you are here and you want to communicate with this person that is in another country. Okay, so what is there in between, there are something called telephone exchange. Okay, so in every telephone exchange there will be a person. Now what you do, you when you want to connect to B, you will call to this person and say I want to connect to B. So this person will call to this person, says that A wants to connect to B. So this person will again connect to this person to call that this A wants to connect to B. Now it is connected to B, and then you can communicate with it. Actually what happens is that when A wants to connect to B, this particular person will complete the circuit by physically taking a wire. So it will place a port, connect the port, and the connection will be established with this particular exchange, and this person here will again establish, it will take a physical port and put it there and complete the circuit. This particular person will be able to communicate with this, connected with this particular person. From this telephone exchange, this particular person will also complete the circuit so that B and this can have a connection. Okay, so everything is manual here. So circuit switching is that you have to complete the circuit by physically placing a wire into the port. Okay, so that is how in earlier days the telephone network worked. Okay, so if you remember, I don't think you know about the early days of telephone, because it was in like 2000 and 2001 and 2 when the telephone network in India became very popular. But at that time, when the telephone network came to India, it was very evolved. But before that, there were many, many things that you do not know about. So I'll tell you about some of the things that the telephone was very easy way to communicate, that is very near to you each other, but that is very near. But to communicate with a far away person, there are so many things that you have to take place. First, you have to contact your telephone exchanges that every time you want to say that I want to talk to that person that lives in that country. So what this do, this particular person notes down your entry in a particular register. Okay, so in that register, there will not be only your entry, but there will be like thousands and thousands of other entries also. Okay, so if you want to call B at 3 p.m. and the connection will not be instant. Okay, so the connection will not be instant. You call this telephone exchange at 3 p.m. so saying that I want to connect to B, but this telephone exchange will note down your entry, and I think it will take around 9 to 10 hours. At that time, it will around 9 to 10 hours to connect to that person. Okay, so most of the time it will be around mid time you will be able to connect to the person, and you cannot ignore the call, because if you ignore the call, now again you have to wait for like 9 to 10 hours for again talking to a respective person. So that was a very big problem then, that because everything was manual. Okay, so the first problem was everything was manual. There is no automatic thing going on. Everything was manual. A person is taking a switch and it is placing into a particular port to form a connection. Okay, so if you are thinking right now, because 1000, if I do a simple communication around many packets are routed. Okay, so the router does this task automatically. It does not require a manual intervention. But if you think this particular internet, if you think that the routing is if the routing is manual, then every person on the earth will be routing the packet for you. Okay, so if anybody used to ask that, what does your son do? So he will say that he functions as a router for a particular place. Okay, so the routers execute millions and millions of entries in like a split second. Okay, so firstly, the problem was it was a manual thing. That is why it is taking so much time to connect to B. And second problem was when the connection is live. Okay, so when you're talking to a person B, all these person that are intermediate here, they can go ahead and listen your call. Okay, so if it is a personal call, I don't think you will be comfortable. It will be a little bit weird that every person is listening whatever you are speaking to other person. Okay, so it will be a lot more weird that if you are just talking useless things, the other person can come, the other person from the telephone exchange can come in between and said that you are not talking any useful things, so I am disconnecting your call. So because there are so many wires in the register, there are so many connection that I have to place today, so I think your time is over. So that can also happen. So second thing was, there was no security or no privacy. Okay, so circuit switching is one beautiful thing is that in circuit switching, the path is already defined. Okay, so it is like a train. Okay, so if a path is ready, your communication will be flawless. Okay, so you can easily be able to communicate with B. Whatever you are sending, the B will receive. Okay, so I'll show you that how much amount of time a particular communication in circuit switching takes. Okay, so now, before calculating the time and other things, now you need to understand that you are coming into the core computer networks. Okay, so everything here, everything now on will be some kind of a numeric thing. Okay, so I'll try to explain it in more as easy terms as possible, but if you don't understand this, just let me know. I will again repeat this particular thing. Okay, so it is very, very easy. First of all, keep in mind that this particular things that I will discuss are very, very easy. So if you are not understanding it, just let me know. It's very easy. If you are not from the computer science background also, if you have a simple knowledge of simple mathematics, that you can easily solve it. Okay? Still, if you are not able to understand, just let me know. Okay, so before discussing the time taken to connect to A to B, I have to tell you about certain times, that is your transmission time, or that is most properly referred to as transmission delay. It is most preferably in your books will be given like that, but it actually is transmission time also. Okay, so it will be denoted like TT. Okay, transmission time or transmission delay. Okay, so another term is propagation delay or propagation time. So delay or time means the same thing, so it will most probably be related by TP. okay, so now I'll talk about transmission delay. I will talk about in simple terms so that there is no need to cram any formula. Okay, so I'll show you how particular formula is formed there. Okay, so now actually, what a transmission delay or a transmission time is, suppose this is your host. Okay, so you are a host, you know, anything which is a computer is a host, and this is the message or a data or the packet. So I'll call it a message or data packet, you can call it, or data packet that you want to send to any other person or any other host or any other computer that is in the link. Okay, so this is a link link can be of wire, it can be guided, it can be unguided. I don't need to worry about that. Okay, so now what exactly is a transmission medium? A transmission delay is time. I'm talking about in very simple terms, time taken to put this particular message onto the link or onto the wire is called a transmission delay. Okay, so I'll write it also. Time taken to put the this I will say message or a data packet, message or a data packet onto the link or onto the wire, onto the wire is called your TT. Okay, so what is a TT? TT is the transmission time. So time taken to put the message onto the wire is called your transmission delay or transmission time. Okay, so if you want to use more formal terms, so put here can be replaced with transmit. Okay, so putting here means transmit that you are sending something. Okay, so what exactly is the transmission delay? Time taken to put this message onto this link is your transmission delay. Simple, in very simple terms. Okay, so I'll take example so you will understand it better. So there is something called a bandwidth. I don't think you will you may have heard about this, but you do not know the actual mean of it. Okay, so if a certain bandwidth is given like this one. Okay, so when there is a b, small b, this means I am talking about in bits, and there is a big b, I will talk about in byte. Okay, so a single byte contain 8 bits. Keep that in mind. Okay, I think 8 bits. Yeah, okay, a single byte contain 8 bits, and yeah, absolutely. Okay, so keep these terms in mind if you are not if you do not have basic in computer science. So keep these two terms in mind. Okay, so here bandwidth means you if you have an internet connection, I will ask you, what is the speed of your internet connection? You probably say that I have a 100 Mbps connection. Okay, so actually this 100 Mbps is your bandwidth. Okay, so that is why here I have written 1 Bps. It means that I'll again write it here so that you can easily understand. It means 1 Bps means that I or you can put 1 bit per second on the link. Okay, so that is the meaning of bandwidth. So what is a bandwidth? It means if it is 1 Bps, it means you can put one bit per second on the link. If you have a 100 Mbps, it means you can put 100 megabits onto the link in 1 second. So that is very simple. Okay, so now if you say that what is this, the size of this particular message, so I'll say that the data packet or the message size or the size of the message is suppose it's 10 bits. Okay, so now what is the time taken, what will be the time taken to put this 10 bits onto the link? Okay, so that will be your transmission time taken to put this message. What is the length of the message? That is 10 bits. Time taken to put this 10 bits onto the link is your transmission time. That is very simple. Now you know 1 bit, the bandwidth is already given, of the bandwidth of this link is already given to you. Okay, so it is given that this link has a bandwidth of 1 bit per second. It means 1 bit can be placed on this link in 1 second. That is very clear to us. 1 bit can be placed onto this link in 1 second. So how much time this 10 bit will take? So 10 bit can be placed on this particular wire in 10 seconds. Okay, so 1 into 10, it is 10 seconds. Okay, so the transmission, now this is your transmission time or your transmission delay to put the message onto the link. Okay, so if you understand it, what is the transmission delay? Transmission time is to put the message onto the link. Time taken to put the message onto the link. So what is the size of the link? The size of the message is 10 bits and the bandwidth of the link is 1 bit per second. So it means that actually I can put 1 bit per second onto the link, I have the capability to put 1 bit per second. Okay, so now what is the message size? Message size is 10 bits. So if I can put 1 bit in 1 second, how many time it will require to put 10 bits? So it will be 10 seconds. Okay, so if you need to figure out the formula, so I'll just replace the terms here. Suppose the size of the packet now, size of the packet or the message size is L bits. And the bandwidth that is given to you is suppose any other term like B bits per second. So it B can be replaced with 10 here. It is no problem there. Okay, so it B can be replaced with 1 here. I don't have any problem. Okay, so now the size of the packet here is L bits. Now in this one was 10 bits, but here it is L bits. Okay, so now I'll ask you, what is the transmission time or transmission delay? So what I'll do, you know that B bits can be placed here in 1 second. So 1 bit will be placed here in 1/b second. So you know about this. This is simple mathematics. I'm not doing anything. So for L bits, so size of the packet is L bits. So how much time will this L bit take? So L bit time will be L by B seconds. Okay. So your transmission time formula is length of the packet or the size of the data packet divided by the bandwidth of the link. Okay, so that is a simple formula of finding out the transmission time. Okay, so if you don't understand anything, just let me know, because it's simple mathematics. I have done nothing. So it is simply that you have to find out that what is the transmission delay. So transmission delay is nothing that to put the message, time required to put the message on a link. Okay, so all the things that are related to it, I've defined bandwidth, I've defined bits, what is a bandwidth, I've defined size of the packet. Now you just have to put the value. Okay, so suppose if I go back here, now I know that the transmission time is length divided by the bandwidth here. What is the length there? The length here was 10 bits. So I put 10 bits here. And what is the bandwidth there? The bandwidth was 1 bit per second. Okay, so it was 1 bit per second. Okay, so I'll place it now, complete it. So it will be bit will be cancelled out by this. Now the answer will be 10 per. So it is a per means here is a per. So per second means, I'll tell you, 1 bit over second. Okay, so it is something like that. And this per, it will be reversed. Now your answer will be 10 seconds. Okay, so you can directly put this formula, but if you do not know this formula, I think you can easily find out what is a transmission time if you know what actually it means. Okay, so if you have any doubt, just let me know. And the next one is your propagation delay, but that propagation delay, I will talk about it in the next one, because again, I do not want to leave that topic in between. Okay, so I'll take some examples there. Okay, so the formula here is TT equal to length by B. So it is already visible that your TT is inversely proportional to your bandwidth, and your TT is directly proportional to the length. Okay, so what exactly it means that if the bandwidth is higher, it means that if your speed is higher, the transmission time will be less. Okay, so if you have a 5 Mbps connection, your internet is slower, but if you have a 10 Mbps connection or 10 Mbps bandwidth, your internet is faster. So that is why the transmission time will be lower. So if you increase the bandwidth, if you have a 100 Mbps connection, your again transmission time will be very, very less, and your internet will be way faster. Okay, so now the transmission time is directly proportional, means that inversely also means that if the bandwidth is less, your transmission time will be higher. Okay, in a similar way, if your length of the packet is more, the transmission time is more, because if the packet size is bigger, there will be more time to put this packet onto the link. So that is why the transmission time will be more. If the length of the packet is small, the transmission time will also be small. Okay, so these are the things. Now I will talk about propagation delay in the next lecture. Okay, you still have any doubt, just let me know. Otherwise, you can move on to the next lecture.